Good morning, students. In the previous class, we had discussed about the Ohm's law and various resistors will be connected in series and parallel. We had calculated the effective resistance when the resistor will be connected in series and parallel. Okay, and then resistivity and temperature dependence of resistivity, alpha for conductor, alpha for semiconductor, all are discussed about in the previous class. In the today's session, we will discuss about the electric cells and batteries. Okay, electric cells and batteries. What are cells? What are called batteries? Okay, then cells, if it be connected in series, it will be calculate the current. That all are discussed in the today's session. Okay, first let us enter this topic. First I explain that power and electrical energy. Okay, how to calculate the power and electrical energy? What is meant by power? Power is nothing but power is equal to change in internal energy by time. Okay, change in electrical energy per time. What is the meaning that change in electrical energy by time? All the phenomena will be done, the work done is always stored as electrical energy. Okay, so normally one process will be done, that the work it will be done in the and in that phenomenon, that the work done will be stored as electrical energy. So electrical energy, it will be called as the work done. So work done is equal to energy is equal to V into Q, R Q into V. Okay, so work done, it will be calculated as V into dQ. Then change in potential energy we want. So dU is equal to dW is equal to V into dQ. Okay, so V is equal to work done. Work done, it will be always stored as electrical energy. Electrical energy formula is, sorry, work done formula is V into Q, potential difference and charge. We want dU. So dU is equal to differentiation of work done, and it will be equal to differentiation of work done, it will be d by dt of V into dq. So V into dq, so V into dq by dt, that's the formula. Okay, so the dq by dt is simply is known as V into dq. Okay, so change in energy, it will be equal to V into dq. Okay, but then we substitute this formula. Power P is equal to d by dt of V for, so change in internal energy dU, so V into dQ. So V into Q, just substitute the V, U value only. U is V into Q. So d by dt of V into Q, that is V into dQ by dt. What is dQ by dt? Change in a number of charges will be flowing at a particular time, it will be called as current. So P is equal to dQ by dt is equal to I. So power P is equal to V into I. How did Kedma? So first, power P is equal to change in electrical energy by time. How will you get the electrical energy formula? So work done is always stored as electrical energy U. Work done formula is V into Q. So dU is equal to dW is equal to V into dQ. And then power, substitute the V value in this formula. V into Q, so V into dQ by dt. V is a constant, so V into dQ by dt. dQ by dt is equal to current I. So power of the formula for power is V into I. Okay, according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. Okay, substitute the V value in this equation. P is equal to V for IR, IR into I, that is I square R. This is the formula for power also. This is the formula for power. This is the formula for power. So P is equal to I square R. So increasing the current value, automatically the power to be increases. Suppose we increase the current in 2 times, the power it will be increases 4 times, because 2 square it will be called as 4. So current and in the square 2 times increase panning enough, power it will be increases by 4 times. And then another one formula, we substitute the I value. According to the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So I is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. So substitute the I value in this equation. Power P is equal to V into V by R. So formula is V square R. This is the formula for power. So power having the three formula, P is equal to V into I, P is equal to I square R, P is equal to V square R. Suppose we increase the voltage in the circuit 2 times, the power it will be increases 4 times, and as well as the current it will be increases by 2 times, and the power it will be increases 4 times. Okay, so there are all the formula for power. Power P is equal to V into I, power P is equal to I square R, power P is equal to V square R. That's a unit of power is watt. Okay. Unit of power is watt, and then largest unit for power is kilowatt. Okay. That is a formula for power. Power is nothing but electrical energy. It will be stored. Power P is equal to change in energy by time. Okay. That is power, and that all are the power formula. This is the unit for power. Next, electrical energy. Electrical energy is nothing but electrical energy is equal to, power is equal to electrical energy by time. So, electrical energy U is equal to power into time. Power into time. Power is always denoted as kilowatt. So, kilowatt into time is always taken as hour. In a home supply current, it will be always taken in the hour portion, not a second. SI unit of time is second, but the electrical energy is used in our day-to-day life with a mention of hour, okay? Kilowatt hour. So, kilowatt, kilo, thousand watt, 1 hour having 60 minutes, 1 minute having 60 seconds. So, 3.6 into 10 power 6 joule, that is called electrical energy. So, electrical energy U is equal to 3.6 into 10 power 6 joule. That's the form value for electrical energy will be consumed per day. Or day ke evlo electrical energy vandu consume agum abingirakana or value 3.6 into 10 power 6. This is the important value. Frequently is asked in 1 words. Okay. So power P is equal to, energy it will be equal to power into time. Energy is kilowatt, time is hour. So kilo 1000 and hour is equal to 60 minutes and 60 seconds. So we easily calculate the multiplying the 3. We get 3.6 into 10 power 6. That is the electrical energy consumed per day. Okay. That is called power and electrical energy. Okay. Then some bulb, in day-to-day lives, we use the various bulbs. Some bulbs will be mentioned the 5 volt and 220 volt and 60 watt and 220 volt. And some bulb are having 50 watt and 220 volt. 220 volt will be the current value, voltage value. Voltage it will be supplied from the alternating current from the electrical board. Electricity board in India will display panakodiya, supply panakodiya voltage of value 220 volt. So it will be common for all the bulbs. But one bulb having the 5 watt, another one bulb having 60 watt, another bulb having 50 watt means that was the power value. That the power it will be explained the efficient of the bulb. Okay. So power it will be calculated by using the electrical energy formula. So various bulbs having various watts and 220 volt supply. Okay, then we will go for cells and batteries. Okay, cells and battery. What is cell, ma? Cell is nothing but we use the remote or electronic car, remote car, remote use panapadi ellame chinna size batteries ellame cells. Okay, cells is nothing but it will be convert the chemical energy into electrical energy. So, using the electrostatic process, electrolytic process will be done in the each cell, that the chemical energy will be transferred to the electrical energy. Cell in the 8th standard, already you learn the chemical effect of electric current. Chemical process will be done in between the electrolyte and electrodes, in between the electrolytic solution to create the chemical energy, that the chemical energy will be converted to the electrical energy. That is called cells. Okay. So various cells will be connected in a one circuit, will be form a battery. So battery will be having various cells to be connected. Okay. So connection of cells, it will be to form a batteries. Then batteries, we use a first current it will be falling from A to B. So the one circuit will be taken. First the circuit having one battery and resistance. Okay. So battery A to B the current will be falling and C to D the current will be falling. First the current will be falling from A to B, A in the B pothu, so battery is there, so it will be gains the electrical energy. Gains the electrical energy. Okay. But C to D it will be loses some electrical energy. Loses some electrical energy. Okay. So this is a electric battery, it will be connected to the one circuit. A to B, the current will be passing through the battery, the electrical energy will be gained by the battery. So the current will be falling from C to D, the electrical energy will be loose from the batteries. Okay. Then both the cases it will be having some electrical energy and easily is calculate the electrical energy will be passed on to the current will be falling to the one circuit. Okay, easily find out. Then next is the internal resistance. Internal resistance, what's the meaning that internal resistance? Before enter this internal resistance, first you should know about electromotive force. Electromotive force. EMF. EMF is nothing force is a one type of force, not like that. Electromotive force is not a force. Okay. So electromotive force is will be voltage supplied by the battery as cell. When no current will be flows in the circuit. In the current may fall ahama or circuit like irundalum, cell and battery supply panakuda or current per da EMF, not a current, voltage. So EMF it will be produced by the cell, it will be given by the cell or battery when no current will be flowing in the circuit. So first, what are cells, what are batteries, and what is electromotive force? Electromotive force, it will be always denoted as psi. Okay, in the simple as psi, sometimes the psi it will be denoted as this. Okay, so psi is the symbol of electromotive force, and then electromotive unit is also volt. Okay, volts. So that is electromotive force. Electromotive force is not a force which just is applied by the battery or cell when no current it will be flowing in the circuit. Okay, that is electromotive force. Now we will go for the internal resistance. What is the meaning that internal resistance, ma? Internally cell having some resistance, not a external resistance to be connected in the circuit. Internally one cell having some resistance, that is called internal resistance. Internal resistance, suppose you have to sometimes the bulb will be glowing after the switch, it will be off. Switch off and paravum sometimes vandu the bulb vandu glowing la irukum. Yen appadina and ulla kuda internal resistance ala some voltage vandu supply aagum. So the internal resistance is nothing but all the cells are having internally some resistance value. So suppose the freshly prepared cell having the low internal resistance, an ideal battery having low internal resistance. Ideal battery means it's a perfect battery, does not having internal resistance. But real battery, what's the meaning that real battery? Battery will be used in more and more electronic appliances. The battery, real battery having the terminal, suppose the battery is there, okay, the battery is there, the battery terminal voltage, we calculate the voltage is between the two terminal voltage, it will be equal to the EMF of the cell. So voltage, terminal voltage, it will be equal to the psi, that is called real battery. Real battery having a low internal resistance. After the increasing the aging of the battery, the internal resistance also increases. So fresh ana or manufacture panirukanga or cell appadina adukku vandu low internal resistance da irukum. So the internal resistance it will be increases as goes on when the age of the battery will be increasing. Yeah, battery age increase internal resistance increase aagum. Okay, so ideal battery and real battery, ideal battery does not having internal resistance, but real battery having terminal voltage, it will be equal to the EMF of the cell. Idoda terminal voltage idoda EMF ku equal appadi irukada real battery. So real battery having the low resistance, freshly prepared cell having the low internal resistance, but it will be increasing with aging. Okay, so how will you calculate the internal resistance in a circuit? Now taking one battery, okay, battery or cell, this is a cell, battery or cell having the internal resistance, the totally it will be is a cell or battery. Okay, then one external resistance will be connected to the circuit, one voltmeter will be connected, the voltmeter reads the voltage it will be flowing in the circuit, or voltage will be drop across the resistance. இந்த ரெசிஸ்டர் நீங்கள் கனெக்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கீங்கன்னா இந்த வழியாக கரண்ட் ஃபாலோ ஆகும்போது இல்லை ஒரு வோல்டேஜ் வந்து நமக்கு வந்து ட்ராப் ஆகும், அந்த வோல்டேஜ் என்னென்னு மென்ஷன் பண்ணுறதுக்கும், தென் இஎம் ஆஃப் த செல்லை மென்ஷன் பண்ணுறதுக்கும் வோல்டிமீட்டர் வச்சுருக்காங்க. ஸோ வோல்டிமீட்டர் ஜஸ்ட் ரீட்ஸ் த வோல்டேஜ் இட் பி ஃப்ளோவிங் இன் த சர்க்கியூட். திஸ் இஸ் த செல் ஹேவிங் த இஎம்எஃப் அண்ட் ஹேவிங் த இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். நவ் வி ஆர் கேல்குலேட் த பொட்டென்ஷியல் ட்ராப் அக்ராஸ் த ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆர் potential drop across the resistance R, it will be equal to potential drop across the resistance R is equal to potential drop across the cell. drop across the cell. Okay, potential drop across the resistance R. The R la pogudiya potential, it will be equal to the EMF la pogudiya potential. Potential is nothing but voltage difference between the two terminals. So the resistance ki inda pagam current difference ke peru dhaan potential. So potential drop across through the resistor R, it will be equal to potential drop across the EMF of the cell. Okay, potential drop across the cell. So how will you calculate the potential difference of the drop across the resistance? According to Ohm's law, the potential is V, V is equal to IR. That is called potential drop across the resistance. Because R is the ohm. R is the resistance connected, voltage V is equal to, voltage or potential is same. So V is equal to IR. This is the formula for potential drop across the resistance R. Then potential drop across the cell, that is called V is equal to psi, because psi is the voltage. So V is equal to psi, but it will be subtract the internal voltage. What is the meaning that internal voltage? Cell will be having the internal resistance. So it will be definitely be create a little bit of voltage. So the total voltage is sum the internal voltage. Internal voltage means voltage V is equal to I into R. So I into internal resistance R. So that is voltage V is equal to EMF minus I into R. Okay. Now we calculate the psi is equal to V plus IR. This is one formula. Psi is equal to V plus IR. Psi is equal to V plus IR. Okay. This is the one formula. And then IR inga vandu V endha pakkam po. So psi minus V. Okay. So IR is equal to V. Now the formula is, again you have to note down, IR is equal to V. The formula will be this. Inge psi is equal to V plus IR. So IR is equal to psi minus V. Okay. This is equation 1. This is equation 2. Divide equation 2 by divide equation 1. 2 by 1 IR by IR is equal to psi minus V by V. Clear that? IR by IR, psi minus V by V. So IR, I cancel. R by R is equal to psi minus V by V. We want R. So that's the internal resistance. So psi minus V by V into R. This is the formula of internal resistance of the cell. How did you calculate, ma? First we choose one battery and having the internal resistance small r, and connect the external resistance R, and voltmeter will be connected across the resistance. Voltmeter reads the voltage drop across the resistor and then cell. Okay, so we in the diagram we consider the potential drop across the resistance R, it will be equal to potential drop across the cell. இதில் ஆரில் க்ராஸ் ஆகக்கூடிய வோல்டேஜ் இட் வில் பி ஈக்குவல் டு த இஎம்எஃப் வோல்டேஜ் ஆஃப் த இஎம்எஃப் சாரி வோல்டேஜ் ஆஃப் த செல். ஓகே, ஸோ பொட்டன்ஷியல் டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் இஸ் ட்ராப் அக்ராஸ் அ செல். ஸோ அக்கார்டிங் டு த ஓம்ஸ்லாம் பொட்டன்ஷியல் ட்ராப் அக்ராஸ் அ ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஐஆர் அண்ட் தென் செல் வி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சை மைனஸ் ஐஆர். வாட்ஸ் த மீனிங் தட் ஐஆர்மா? டோட்டல் இஎம்எஃப் மைனஸ் இன்டர்னலி சம் வோல்டேஜ் இட் வில் பி கிரியேட்டட். இன்டர்னல் கிரியேட் ஆகக்கூடிய வோல்டேஜ் நம்ம சப்ராக்ட் பண்ணால் தான் அதோடைய டோட்டல் இஎம்எஃப் வந்து கிடைக்கும். ஸோ வி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சை மைனஸ் ஐஆர். ஸோ சை இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு வி ப்ளஸ் ஐஆர். தென் ஐஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஐஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சை மைனஸ் வி. ஓகே, தென் டிவைடிங் ஈக்குவேஷன் 2 பை 1 ஐஆர் பை ஐஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சை மைனஸ் வி பை வி. ஓகே, ஸோ ஆர் பை ஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சை மைனஸ் வி பை வி. ஆர் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு சை மைனஸ் வி பை வி இன்ட் ஆர். This is the formula for total internal resistance in the circuit. So total internal resistance is nothing but some resistance will be created inside of the cell. How will you calculate? Potential drop across in the both the electronic devices, it will be considered. And now the resistance value, it will be calculated. Then now the power P, it will be calculated. Power P in the internal resistance having circuit. One circuit will be having the internal resistance R, one cell will be having the internal resistance. How will you calculate the power? Power V is equal to P is equal to V into I. Just change I into V, it's both the same. But V is equal to, substitute that I, V it will be cell. So we consider that V is a psi, because cell, the voltage of the cell is psi. ஸோ நார்மலி நம்ம ஒரு எலக்ட்ரிக் சர்க்கியூட்னா அந்த வீன் எடுத்துக்கணும். செல்லுன்னு எடுக்கும்போது வி வோல்டேஜ் தான் அதோட இஎம்எஃப், தட் இஸ் சை. ஸோ சப்ஸ்டிட்யூட் த சை வேல்யூ ஐ இன்ட்டு வி ப்ளஸ் ஐஆர். psi is equal to V plus IR. So V plus IR. Then V is equal to, according to Ohm's law, IR. So I into R plus I into small r. Okay. Then multiplying two sides. I square R plus I square R. So power P is equal to having power of the one circuit having the internal resistance, external resistance and internal resistance is equal to I square R plus I square R. ஒரு சர்க்கியூட்டில் எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸும் இருக்குது, ஒரு செல் கனெக்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க, அந்த செல்லுக்கு இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் இருக்குது. அப்படின்னா அதோடைய பவர் பி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர் ப்ளஸ் ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர். ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர் இஸ் த பவர் இஸ் டெலிவர் டு த எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர் இட் வில் பி ஈக்குவல் டு பவர் இட் வில் பி டெலிவர் டு த இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ பவர் இஸ் டெலிவர் டு த எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ், பவர் இட் வில் பி டெலிவர் டு த இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். சப்போஸ் ஒன் செல் எல்லாமே ஹேவிங் லோவஸ்ட் ஆர் வேல்யூ இஸ் வெரி ஸ்மால், R value is very small. So, suppose the cell having low internal resistance, R square R, it will be very much less than the R square, sorry, I square R, I square R, it will be very much greater than the I square R. So, the power, it will be completely, entire power, it will be delivered to the external resistance. இதோடு உங்களுக்கு புரியுதா? Power calculate பண்ணியிருக்கோம், power உடைய value I square R plus I square R. இந்த இடத்துல பவர் வந்து எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ்க்கு டெலிவர் ஆகும் ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர் ஃபார்முலாவில். ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆரில் பவர் இட் பி டெலிவர் டு த இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த செல். சப்போஸ் த இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வேல்யூ இஸ் வெரி ஸ்மால், இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் வெரி ஸ்மால் கம்பேரபிள் டு ஐ ஸ்கொயர் ஆர், த என்டையர் பவர் இட் பி டெலிவர் டு த எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ், என்டையர் பவர் இட் பி டெலிவர் டு த ஹோல் சர்க்யூட். ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் கால் பவர். ஸோ நவ் வாட் ஆர் செல்ஸ், வாட் ஆர் பேட்டரிஸ் அண்ட் ஹவு the internal resistance will be created in the cell, and then we calculate the formula for internal resistance. We have discussed to find out the power of the circuit having the internal resistance and external resistance. Okay, then we will go for how the cells to be connected in series and parallel we get the current value. So how will you get already you learned capacitor will be connected in series and parallel and resistor to be connected in series and parallel. Effective capacitor or effective resistance to be calculated in the previous classes. In the today's session, we connect cells to be connected in series and parallel. Cells, what is the meaning that cell ma? Cell batteries. Batteries means a simple batteries. Cell, okay? So positive charge and negative charge. Having the two terminal, positive and negative. The cells to be connected in series and parallel. First, cell it will be connected in series. Series mean one terminal, it will be connected to another one terminal. Sorry, second terminal of the first cell, it will be connected to the first terminal of the second cell. Second terminal of the second cell, it will be connected to the first terminal of the third cell. And second terminal of the third cell, it will be connected to the first terminal of the fourth cell. Okay, it will be connected in series, the continuously the cells to be connected. Okay, then one resistor will be connected with through the all the cells. So four cells is there, four cells will be connected with the resistance R. Parallel, the cells will be connected one by one. One by one means the two terminals will be attached with the two terminal of the second cell, and second two terminal will be attached with the third two terminal of the cells. So and then resistance will be also calculated connected. Then now we will calculate the current value. The current will be flowing in the all the cells. How will you calculate? ஸோ கரண்ட் கேல்குலேட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு கரண்ட் வேணால் நமக்கு என்ன வேணும், அக்கார்டிங் டு ஓம்ஸ் லா வி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஐஆர். ஸோ வி வாண்ட் கரண்ட், ஸோ ஐ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு வி பை ஆர். ஸோ நவ் வி வாண்ட் வோல்டேஜ் அண்ட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் அ க்வெஸ்சன், திஸ் இஸ் அ செல். ஸோ ஐ இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு வி இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் சை. ஸோ சை பை ஆர், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி வாண்ட் சை அண்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் வி வாண்ட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சை, சை மீன்ஸ் இஎம்எஃப். ஓகே, இஎம்எஃப் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் சை. So in series, in parallel, correspondingly I explained that series and parallel. Students, please note down all the steps to be followed to derive the cells to be connected in series. Derive the electric current when the cells are to be connected in series and parallel. It will be simple way to learn the detail. Cell app series out parallel out connect pannirukom appadina nearly 3 pages irukum book la idu short form la ipdi neenga eludhi vechittingina easier irukum ungalku padikkiradhu. Okay, so first we explain the emf. Emf psi is equal to n into psi because n cells is there. Okay, n cells, so multiplying n cells means 4 cells. So actually 4 into psi da varum. Suppose we connected the very many number of cells. So taken as n number of cells will be connected in series, so n into psi. This part, the cells will be connected below to below, one by one. So one by one, it will be simply, it will be mentioned as psi, not a number of cells, because the current will be flowing in a one cell in a one time, and another one cell, it will be another one time, it will be continuous process, it will be done. So this part, it will be n into psi, and this part is very one psi. Okay, then second one, total resistance. Total resistance R is equal to one resistance is there, and then all the cells are having internal resistance. So n into R. So total resistance is equal to resistance in the electric cells. Resistance in the electric cells small r, but number of cells is there. So n into R plus total plus the external resistance. So total resistance is equal to n R plus R. Okay, n series. But parallel effective resistance will be calculated. So n of the resistance will be connected in series. So the effective equivalent resistance 1 by R is equal to 1 by R plus 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So resistance and in the parallel connect panikkomna enna panuvom 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the way we will calculate. Okay, but in this question R1, R2, R3 value is not there. Some cells will be connected having some internal resistance. So 1 by R is equal to n number of cells into 1 by R plus 1 by R plus up to that sum of R. So 1 by R is equal to n number of R. So n by R. N numbers na evlo cells namak theriyadu. So number of cells n by R. So R is equal to 1 by R is equal to n by R. R is equal to R by n. Reciprocal. So R is equal to R by n. Idu vandu internal resistance. Now we will calculate the total resistance. Total resistance is equal to internal resistance of the EMF, internal resistance of the cell plus external resistance R. So internal resistance we calculate R by N plus external resistance small, capital R. So R is equal to taking the LCM N into R. So R plus NR by N. R plus NR by N. Okay. So R plus NR by N. Then this is the total resistance. So this is EMF and that is total resistance. The series connection, this is the EMF, this is the total resistance. Okay. So total resistance will be calculated the sum of the internal resistance and then external resistance. In the parallel connection, the total resistance R is equal to internal resistance plus N the external resistance by N. Okay. So this two values already we calculate. Next we will go for current I. Current I is equal to, already I told, current I is according to Ohm's law, I is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. We taking the cells, so we mention the V instead of psi. So psi by R is equal to, we substitute the psi value and substitute the R value, total resistance value. Substitute the psi value, that is N into psi, and R value is NR plus R. Okay. Psi value வையும் R value இங்க substitute பண்ணி n psi by nr plus r னு calculate பண்ணிக்கங்க. This is the current in the cells will be connected in series. Now in parallel I is equal to substitute the psi value and substitute the r value. Psi value is psi and then r value is r plus nr by n. R plus nr by n. So taking denominator part will be in the numerator n into psi by nr plus r. Okay. N மேல போச்சுன்னா n psi by nr plus r. This is the current value. So this is the current formula for when the cells will be connected in series. This is the current formula for when the cells will be connected in parallel. Okay. So first psi value will be calculated in both series and parallel, and resistance will be calculated in series and parallel. Now the current will be calculated in series and parallel. Okay. Now we taking the two cases. R, internal resistance will be greater than the external resistance. Internal resistance, it will be less than the external resistance. Circuit la nariya cells irukku, external resistance irukku. Suppose and the cells la irukku kuda internal resistance R avida adhigama irundha enna varum, R avida kammiya irundha enna agum. So we taking the two cases. So first R will be greater than R. R will be very much greater than the capital R, external resistance. So external resistance nam inda R avida inda R vandu adhigama irukku appadina we remove the capital R, so n psi by nr. Small r, capital R, it will be very much smaller than the small r. So n r it will be neglected, n psi by n r is equal to psi by r, n and cancel, psi by r is the formula for current. Okay, nothing changed. Normally the cells will be connected in series, the current will be always taken as the current value. Okay, then in parallel I is equal to we taking r is greater than r, small r will be greater than capital R. So capital R will be neglected, n psi by r, n psi by r, psi by r is current. So taking the new current, that is I1, n into I1. Okay, this formula only get this formula n into I, because number of cells will be connected in parallel. So n into current value I1. Okay, this is the maximum value, this is the normal value. Okay, then second case, R it will be very much less than the capital R. So capital R only greater. So capital R only it will be greater comparable to the small r, will be neglected this term, n psi by r, psi by r it will be equal to I1. So n into I1. Okay, this case, n psi by n r plus r. Okay, so this part r it will be taken as cancel, because r it will be very much less than the capital R. So n psi by n r, so n and cancel, psi by r, that will be taken as I. So the two cases will be taken, r it will be greater than r, r it will be less than r. R greater than r in series, I it will be only giving the normal current value. But r less than r, the current value it will be produced when the cells will be connected in series, number of currents. So R எந்த இடத்துல ஸ்மாலாக இருக்குதோ அந்த இடத்துல தான் நமக்கு என்ன ஆகுது, ஆர் இஸ் ஸ்மாலர் தென் கேபிட்டல் ஆர், இந்த இடத்துல தான் மேக்ஸிமம் வேல்யூ கிடைக்குது. ஸோ என்னிட்டு I1. ஸோ வி டேக்கிங் த மேக்ஸிமம் கரண்ட் வேல்யூ வென் ஸ்மாலர் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வில் பி வெரி மச் லெஸ் தென் த கேபிட்டல் ஆர். ஸோ ஆர் இஸ் ஸ்மாலர் தென் கேபிட்டல் ஆர். தென் திஸ் பார்ட் ஆர் இஸ் திஸ் இஸ் ஆர் இஸ் கிரேட்டர் தென் ஆர், திஸ் இஸ் ஆர் இஸ் லெஸ் தென் ஆர். விச் ஒன் இஸ் கிரேட்டர் மா, திஸ் ஒன் இஸ் கிரேட்டர். ஸோ ஆர் it will be very much greater than the smaller than the r. R value எப்போ வந்து அதிகமாக இருக்கும், இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வேல்யூ எப்போ அதிகமாக இருக்குதோ அப்போ தான் அதோடைய மேக்ஸிமம் கரண்ட் வேல்யூ கிடைக்கும். ஸோ வென் த செல்ஸ் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் சீரீஸ் அண்ட் பேரலல், நத்திங் கிவிங் த மோர் அட்வான்டேஜஸ் டு கனெக்டிங் த சிங்கிள் செல். ஸோ ஆல்வேஸ் ப்ரொடியூசிங் த வோல்டேஜ் இட் வில் பி கிரியேட்டட் பை த சிங்கிள் செல். ஸோ த செல்ஸ் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் பேரலல் அஸ் சீரீஸ். The total current or total voltage is nothing, it will be giving the greater value comparable to the single cell. ஒரு single cell கனெக்ட் பண்ணுறதுக்கும் செல்லை சீரீஸாவோ பேரலாவோ கனெக்ட் பண்ணுறதுக்கும் எந்த அட்வான்டேஜஸுமே இருக்காது. பட் ஒன்லி திங்க், இன் சீரீஸ் கனெக்ஷன் ஸ்மால் இன்டர்னல்ஸ்னு வெரி ஸ்மால் த சீரீஸ் கனெக்ஷன். சீரீஸாக நீங்கள் செல்லை கனெக்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க அப்படின்னா அதோட இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸை விட கம்மியாக இருக்கும், அது ஒரு அட்வான்டேஜ். தென் பட் பேரலே கனெக்ட் பண்ணிங்கன்னா the external resistance is smaller than the internal resistance. So internal resistance will be higher than the external resistance. So externally, normally the cells will be connected in series and parallel, nothing giving the advantages than the single cell. Single cell விட எந்த அட்வான்டேஜுமே கிடையாது. Normally the current will be producing, it will be equal to the current will be producing in a single cell. But only advantages is the cells will be connected in series, the internal resistance will be very small. Okay, so how will you calculate the cells will be connected in parallel? So we fix the cells will be connected in series and parallel. First we find out the EMF and total resistance. Okay, EMF in series n into psi and total resistance r is equal to number of cells in the internal resistance plus external resistance capital R. And then so total resistance is equal to r is equal to nr plus r. And then current it will be calculated, I is equal to psi by R, that is the EMF of the cell by resistance. So substituting the psi value, substituting the resistance value. Now we take R it will be greater than R, internal resistance it will be very much greater than the capital R, so the external resistance, we calculate the current in the current. Current value it will be giving the same current value. And then we take R less than small r, the current it will be calculated as the n number of the currents. So now the voltage will be created by the cells will be connected in series, it will be giving the same value, it will be voltage will be supplied by the single cell. So more nothing advantages is there, but the internal resistance is very much smaller than the external resistance. But it will be connected in parallel, we calculate the resistance. First current was EMF is psi, but resistance will be calculated. When the resistance will be connected in parallel, the effective resistance will be calculated. R is equal to R by N. Then substitute the total resistance value. R is equal to R plus NR by N. Substitute the current is equal to psi by R. So psi value substitute and R value substitute. And N psi by NR plus R. We taking R greater than R, R less than R. R greater than R. We consider the internal resistance is very much greater than the external resistance. Now the current value is n number of times the current value, and then R less than R, the current is equal to N psi by NR, that is psi by R, that's the current value. So this is the in connected in parallel, external resistance will be smaller than the internal resistance. In the today's session, we are discuss about the what is electric power, what is electrical energy, what is electric power, ma? Power P is equal to V into I, power P is equal to I square R, power P is equal to V square R, and then power unit of power is watt, okay, and the larger unit of power is kilowatt. Some bulb, different bulbs having a different power, okay. Then electrical energy will be calculated in power in the time. So what's the value is in electrical energy, power in the time, that is 3.6 into 10 power 6 joule, that is called power, sorry, that is called electrical energy. And then power and electrical energy, then say what are cells, the chemical energy, the cells it will be converts chemical energy into electrical energy. What are batteries, the cells it will be more cells will be connected to form a battery. Then what is electromotive force, electromotive force just the voltage is supplied by the cell when no current will flows in the circuit, okay, that is EMF. EMF will be denoted as psi, okay. And then how the cells to be, then internal resistance is a definite ideal battery does not having no internal resistance, but real battery means terminal voltage will be equal to the EMF of the cell. So the real battery having the low internal resistance, freshly prepared cell having low internal resistance, but you have to, this will be increases with the aging. Age increases, then internal resistance will be also increases. Then calculate the internal resistance value. Internal resistance value R is equal to E minus I minus V by V into R. And then taking the power, it will be calculated. Power is equal to V into I. According to the internal resistance, the power to be calculated. And then how will you calculate the electric current when the cells will be connected in series and parallel? Series and parallel, we first calculate, we make the circuit with the cells will be connected in series and parallel. And then EMF, total resistance we calculate. So EMF and total resistance and current to be calculated, we consider the two cases. And then how the current it will be calculated when the cells will be connected in series and parallel, and no changes it will be in the, no changes is there when the single cell will be created with current with versus the current will be created to the series connection cells. Series connect cell connect பண்றதுக்கும் parallel connect பண்ணும்போது உள்ள இதுக்கும் நார்மலி ஒரு செல் கொடுக்கக்கூடிய வோல்டேஜுக்கும் நிறைய டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் இருக்காது. பட் த இன்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் வெரி மச் ஸ்மாலர் தென் த எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் இன் த வென் த செல்ஸ் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் சீரிஸ். ஸோ டுடே ஹோம் அசைன்மெண்ட், ஹோம் அசைன்மெண்ட் ஃபார் டுடே செஷன், learn the derivation part, learn and write the derivation part of cells in parallel, cells in series and parallel. Okay students, now on the homework, learn and write the derivation part of cells are connected in series and parallel. Okay, thank you.